Hello everyone, this is easyedu and today we will be learning about energy and momentum and how they fit together in relativity. We will derive an equation that will relate total energy, the rest energy and momentum of a particle. This equation will be valid for all frame of references, where the frame is inertial frame of reference or whether it is non-inertial frame of reference. Let's begin with Einstein's equation, E is equal to mc square. But in relativity, we can write this equation as E is equal to gamma mc square, where gamma is equal to 1 over under root 1 minus v square by c square. Now, putting the value of gamma in this equation, we will get E is equal to mc square divided by under root 1 minus v square by c square. Now, by taking square on both sides of the equation, it will becomes E square is equal to this term, which is m square c k power 4 divided by 1 minus v square c square. Now, we deal with momentum. We know that linear momentum of a body is given as p is equal to mv. But in relativity, this equation becomes p is equal to gamma mv, where gamma is 1 over under root 1 minus v square by c square. Putting this value of gamma in equation number 3, the momentum becomes p is equal to mv divided by under root 1 minus v square by c square. Now, squaring both sides of the equation becomes p square is equal to m square c square divided by 1 minus v square c square. Now, multiply c square with left side as well as with the right side. This c square term and this c square term, the equation becomes p square c square is equal to m square v square c square and whole divided by 1 minus v square by c square. We name this equation as equation number 4. Now we have two equations, one for energy and the other one is for momentum. For energy, it is E square, and for momentum, we have derived this equation, which is P square C square. Now, we will subtract equation number 4 from equation number 2. By doing this, we will subtract P square C square from E square, and we will subtract this term from this one. Here you see, E square minus P square C square is equal to this term minus this term. Now we know that the base of this term is equal to the base of this term. So by simply taking LCM and taking M square C square common from this equation, the equation will become E square minus P square C square is equal to, taking this term common, the remaining term is only C square, where from here the remaining term is only V square. C square minus V square and bases are the same. This the LCM is 1 minus V square by C square. Now we will take another C square common from this equation. Again, then when we take C square from this equation common, the remaining term here will be 1 and minus this will become v square divided by c square. Now this term is equal to the remainder. Now this term will cancel with this term and the remaining terms are e square minus p square c square is equal to m square c square dot c square. Eventually, this equation will become equal to E square is equal to P square C square plus MC square whole square. Now, this equation which we have derived relate the energy, momentum and mass of particle and relativity. We have fitted together the energy, momentum and mass of object. This equation can also be written in this form. Now, what will be the energy of a particle which have mass is equal to zero? Like photons have rest mass is equal to zero. Now, what will be the energy of photons? We put m is equal to zero in equation number 6. E is equal to p square c square plus mc square whole square. By putting this m is equal to zero, then the equation becomes E is equal to whole under root p square c square plus zero. E is equal to p square c square whole square root. The square root with cancel with square, and the remaining term is E is equal to pc. And here you see this is the energy of a massless particle like photon, where c is the speed of light and p is momentum of photons. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe easyedu for more videos. Thank you.